Instrument Air System Part 6. Here we are going to talk about heatless regenerative air dryer. Air dryer. Instrument air dryers are in use in the power industry, generally fall into the following types: desiccant, heat regenerative, desiccant, heatless regenerative, refrigeration. Numerous manufacturers produce the various types of dryers. A discussion of the theory of operation of desiccant, heatless, regenerative type air dryer follows. The manufacturers have different designs and controls, but the overall operation is similar. But before proceeding any further, one has to understand the term air purge regeneration. Air purge regeneration. The most common regenerative process is air purge regeneration. A common regenerative dryer system where the wet towel is dried by diverting a small flow of the dry air from the active drying towel back through the saturated towel. This dry air absorbs the moisture and expels it to the atmosphere. This dryer type accomplishes the required dew point reduction and adds some inefficiencies to the instrument air unit by either utilizing some of the system's horsepower or adding extra electrical power requirements to the system. The consideration for this regeneration cost must be applied to the initial sizing of the compressor unit. Air purge regeneration. Air purge system is the simplest system to implement. The airflow requirement for regeneration is usually 15 to 20% of the total air flow. The image shown illustrates the moisture-laden air is flowing through and being dried in tower 1, while tower number 2 is being regenerated using for use once the first tower is saturated. So here the tower 1 is working, it is drying the air, and the dried air is going out like this, and the some percent of that air is being utilized for regenerating the tower 2, and this dry air is absorbing the moisture from tower 2 and the moisture is coming out in the purge form. The image shown indicates a reversal of process where tower number 2 is drying the airflow and tower number 1 is in the regeneration mode. request. It is hoped that this lecture is going to be useful to you. Please press like. Please subscribe. Once we have understood the term air purge regeneration, now we are ready for heatless regenerative dryer. In the next slide, little bigger diagram is there. In this diagram, we can see the main parts: dryer control panel, left tower, right tower, dryer inlet, dryer outlet. Regarding the other components, we shall get familiar with them during the presentation of next few slides. In heatless regenerative desiccant dryers, the moist inlet air enters the dryer through the inlet switching valve A and is routed to either the right or left tower. While the air flows through the tower, the moisture is absorbed onto the desiccant. After drying, the air leaves the dryer outlet. This is the dryer outlet C. Regeneration of the offline tower is accomplished by taking 15 to 20% of the dry outlet air and routing it through the offline tower and then to atmosphere via the purge muffler. This is the purge muffler D. Regeneration and drying cycles are controlled by using either timers or moisture probes. The moisture probes sense the moisture content of the desiccant. The purge control throttle valve is adjusted to ensure proper flow rate of the purge air throughout the regenerating tower for optimum regeneration efficiency. The tower repressurization valve provides for a slow repressurization of the regenerated tower before it is placed back online to reduce the pressure surge in the tower and the resultant compaction and breakdown of the desiccant. The control air isolation valve isolates the air to the control panel. These dryers usually operate on 10-minute cycles. This type of dryer may starve the distribution system in plants with marginal capacity due to their high purge air requirements. Before installing a heatless desiccant type dryer, ensure that the compressors have 15 to 20% excess capacity. Here we can see a typical twin tower regenerative desiccant type dryer. We can see here the control panel, and here is the left tower, and here is the right tower. Next lecture. The next lecture shall be Instrument Air System Part 7. In this lecture, some other important component of the instrument air system shall be discussed. Request. It is hoped that this lecture is useful to you. Please press like. Please subscribe.